I can't speak to that either. I was interviewed by her kind of to corroborate Jackie's story, and I can say that everything Jackie told me over a year ago is exactly what was published and exactly what Jackie did tell me.
Annie Forrest is one of the first people Jackie spoke to about the alleged gang rape inside a University of Virginia fraternity house, a horrifying story with graphic detail that became the focus of Rolling Stone's explosive story. Forrest told us she spoke to Jackie Sunday night.
We just kind of talked about how she's feeling right now and how absolutely overwhelmed she is, how she really didn't see any of this coming.
Since Rolling Stone issued an apology to readers Friday, there's been nonstop speculation about whether the incident happened as Jackie recalled, or if it happened at all. But before Rolling Stone even published the story, another one of Jackie's friends tells CNN Jackie was concerned.
Was she apprehensive about the article?
She was terrified. I remember her just, she was absolutely terrified of the repercussions.
Repercussions started against the fraternity, the house getting vandalized. Now some of that backlash has shifted to Jackie.
While there do appear to be holes in her story, no survivor I've ever spoken to tells a straight, linear account of their story until years and years after therapy.
In the article, Jackie says that she was brought here by a fraternity brother for a party at the Phi Kappa Psi house. But once she got inside, she says he took her upstairs to a dark room where she was attacked and raped by seven men, while two others looked on. One of the major discrepancies is that Rolling Stone says Jackie escaped down a side staircase and out a side door. The attorney for Phi Kappa Psi tells us there's no side staircase inside the house, but there are side doors, and this one has an exterior side staircase.
Phi Kappa Psi's attorney also tells CNN records show there was no party the night the gang rape allegedly occurred. And the attorney says the man who Jackie says lured her to the room was never even a member of the fraternity. Rolling Stone revised its apology over the weekend to say it takes responsibility for any inaccuracies in the story and the blame does not lie with Jackie.
On Monday, the university announced it's establishing a committee to study cultural issues here at the University of Virginia, including sexual assault and binge drinking. Sara Ganim, CNN, Charlottesville, Virginia.